Welcome back to Welcome Home. I'm Rachel Schramm with Simply Home, and we are back with Amanda Gates, feng shui expert. Yes. With Gates Interior Design. Tell me, first of all, how does one get into becoming an expert on feng shui?
It's actually a really funny story. I was a pre-med student, and I was going to med school, and my then husband and I, we had purchased the best worst house in the best neighborhood, and I was having a lot of weird issues, and I had this very surreal moment. I was in a Borders bookstore of all places, and I was like, if I can just make the house prettier, all the weird stuff will go away. And this woman walked up to me and she said, "Darling, you don't need those books, you need that book." And it was a feng shui book.
Wow, that's what started it all. I love it.
Dropped out of med school and I was like, this is what I need to be doing. That's how passionate I was about it.
So we've all heard the term for years, but what the heck is feng shui? Tell us.
It's such a great question because we hear it a lot in pop culture, and I think a lot of people have probably read an article here or there. It's been in Cosmo and things like that. And I think it gets really misconstrued as a superstition, or it's voodoo, or a religion, I've heard it. But really what it is it's energy medicine. It's looking at something that may be going wrong in your life, and rather than looking to external things, we're looking at your home to try to fix it. So I always tell people, visualize a kinked hose. So we've all been washing our car, we've been, maybe out in the garden, and like the water's trickling out of the hose, and it's like, oh darn it, it's kinked. And you walk over, you unkink it, and the water comes flowing out. That to me is a perfect explanation of feng shui. If you've got something that's going wrong in your life, I can look at your floor plan and go, there's the kink right there. We can unkink it and things start flowing again.
I love that. That's a great analogy. So tell me, if I'm in my home and something maybe feels off, how do I know if feng shui is off? How do I know to call you?
Yeah, well, that's a great question. I mean, if something is off in your life, it's likely showing up in your floor plan. In my world, we call that qi. So the qi is kinked somewhere. And so I always tell people, pay attention to your language. You know, if you find yourself going, oh, I keep getting passed up for that promotion. Mm-hmm. Oh, I can't get pregnant. Oh, I just always feel drained. Pay attention to what you're saying, because it's clues as to what's showing up energetically in your home.
So does mindset have something to do with it? A little bit,
uh-huh. But it's more if you remember Charlie Brown, remember Pigpen and the tornado that was always going around
him? Yes.
Well, we have an EMF around us. We have an EMF in our heartbeat, and we also have an EMF coming off of our brain.
Okay.
And so the things that we feel really emotional about and the things that loop in our head are in our tornado. So those are things that are imprinting on our homes. And so if you can, pay attention to what you're saying and what you're feeling and what's showing up in your life, you can get your personal qi in order, and then you can get the qi of your home in order and unkink that hose.
I love it. I'm learning a lot today that I didn't know. So you touched on it a little bit about maybe the things that aren't happening in your life and this can help, but specifically, how can feng shui benefit someone?
Well, again, if you've got something that comes up again and again, like say you are trying to get pregnant, or you keep getting passed up at work for that promotion, you're like, oh my God, like I've been here 16 years, why am I not getting this promotion? Something in the energy is kinked in your home. And I think what a lot of people do is they seek external things for something in their life that keeps occurring again and again. They'll hire a guru, they start eating right, they get a bunch of self-help books, and people never look at their home as a possible solution. And I think that that's the first place you should start.
That's great advice. We talked earlier in the show about new construction and custom builds and things like that. So you've touched on maybe if you have an existing home, feng shui being off. Mm-hmm. Talk a little bit about if you're building completely from the ground up, new construction, maybe you're moving your current furniture into it, or you're redesigning or designing for the first time. Kind of what are some of those things that you think about and look for and plan for when creating a new space?
Well, there's no such thing as a perfect home. Mm-hmm. A lot of people will say, oh, well, if I could, if I had all the money in the world, I would just build from the ground up and I would build the perfect feng shui home. And it doesn't exist because we all have tornadoes. So whatever's in your energy field is what's literally going to be built. So even if you're working with an architect and you're like, I'm going to build the perfect feng shui home, all of that energy soup is getting drawn onto the paper. So whatever you've got going on in your life is going to be the imprint on that. So the best thing that you can do is recognize it, work with a practitioner, and then adjust it. as you go through life, because your intentions throughout life are going to change.
Sure.
And so is your feng shui.
So if someone's sitting here thinking, I think I need a feng shui guru.
Everybody does.
Right? I'm thinking we need a feng shui guru. Tell me about where folks can find you.
The best thing is just to go to my website, which is gatesinteriordesign.com. I have all of my information on there, and I've got a lot of great ways for you to connect with me and to start your feng shui magic.
That sounds great. Well, thank you so much for being here. We didn't get to a lot of information, so I know folks can find that on your website, but we need to have you back on and talk about the disruptors and maybe some more specifics.
That would be great.
Thank you so much.
Thanks.
Well, thank you all for watching this month's episode as well. As always, I hope you found some helpful home info that you can use. And if the busy housing market has you thinking about buying or selling, please reach out at rachelschramm.com and let me know how I can help.